Hello again. I'm Wayne with the VA's Veterans Health Administration. This is the second video on a five-part VA Beneficiary Travel Self-Service System, or BTS3 for short. In this video, I'm going to show you how to set up your electronic fund transfer or direct deposit and how to review your BTS3 profile. To set up your direct deposit for the VA, if you already haven't done so, to set up direct deposit, you will need to complete and return VA Form 10091. You will need your bank's name, your account number, your routing number, and if the account is a checking or savings account to complete the form. To obtain this form, you'll contact the Beneficiary Travel Office or go to www.va.gov/findforms and search for 10091. It will be the first form and it'll be titled FSC Vendor File Request. You need to do this in order to set up your direct deposit for the electronic fund transfer. The instructions to the form are found on the back. Once you've completed the form, you can either mail it to the address you see in front of you, secure fax it, or hand carry it to your beneficiary travel office nearest you. If you have any questions, you can call the Fiscal Service Center at area code 512-460-5380. Here is what the form 10091 looks like. On the left-hand side of the form, you will check the new block and the veteran block in the payee vendor type field. You then fill out the following sections: the date, your social security number, your name in the vendor block, your phone number, address, the bank's name, routing number, account number. Check the block next to it whether it's checking or a savings account. Print your name and then your signature below that. A quick reminder on how to access your BTS3. You will go to the Access VA webpage, choose I am a veteran. You then select the veteran travel claim entry icon. Log in using your DS logon, ID me, or My Healthy Vet username and password, and accept the secure logon redirect. You might have to wait for BTS3 to load. Then you'll read and agree to the terms and conditions by checking the box next to Proceed to Profile, and then hit the Continue button. You will not be able to click the Proceed to Profile review until you have checked the box I agree to terms and conditions. This will turn the profile review to green. This is your profile. Your profile review will include your residential address, which will be used to determine your starting point for your mileage payment. Your direct deposit information will be in the banking information block. It could be your bank's name, account number, or routing number, or it could be your direct express card information. If there is no banking information, you will receive a paper check. Be aware if you do not have banking information and you receive paper checks, they will take a minimum of 30 days to reach you. Only if you enter information into the profile blocks will request profile update become eligible to click. If you do not request any updates, then it will not be available. If you do request updates, be mindful that it will take a few days for the clerk to update your profile. It will not take effect immediately. You will receive notice once these updates are complete. If there's nothing you need to update, then you will click the Proceed to Dashboard button. This is what your dashboard looks like and where you'll start when you have to request travel reimbursement. We will cover that more in our next video. Thank you for watching.